So today we would be learning about normal anatomy in CT thorax, how to identify the structures. First of all, how do we identify a CT scan? Is by looking at the bones. So bones are white on CT. To be specific, always look at the bone cortex. So here the bone cortex plus the medulla is white. This is a CT scan. Next you have to identify whether it's a contrast or a non-contrast CT. So always try and look at the vessels in the image. So these are the vessels number 3 and number 5. They are white, that's why it's a contrast scan. In a non-contrast, the vessels will be grey colored. Now you see the soft tissues, the muscles, these are grey. So the soft tissues are grey. The black areas are the air. Remember the basic concept, black on X-ray or CT is air or fat. Fat is less black, air is more black. White on a CT scan is either bones or acute hemorrhage or calcification. So looking at this first section, the uppermost section of the CT thorax, number one, this is the white structure, so that is a bone. This is the scapula, that's the coracoid process anteriorly. This is the humerus. What you see here, number 9 bone, that is the scapula again, because it is the posterior most bone in the thorax. So on either side, posterior scapula. These are the clavicles. This is the vertebra. This is the posterior process, that is the spinous process of the vertebra. So these are the bones here. Now what do you see here in the center? The black rounded structure, that is the trachea, because it contains air, that is why it is black. Surrounding the trachea anteriorly here, you see this thyroid gland. Very important to identify the thyroid gland. So that's the thyroid. Remember that thyroid appears hyperdense on plain CT also because it contains iodine. Now these are the vessels here adjacent to the thyroid. The smaller vessel, this white dot, is the common carotid artery. So that's the right common carotid artery, structure 3. This structure 5, which is the larger vessel adjacent to the thyroid, that is the internal jugular vein. So this is the left internal jugular vein, medial to it the common carotid artery. The vessel here, number 7, is the subclavian vein. You see this artifact coming here, the white and this artifact. It is because we have pushed the contrast in the left upper limb of the patient, so it gives artifact here. Coming to the next lower slide, again we see here that this is the trachea, the black structure containing air. Structure number 2, this is this round structure just posterior to the trachea. We know that it is esophagus. This structure 4 here, we saw that that is the subclavian vein into which we have injected the contrast. That is why it's appearing white here. This we saw is humerus, the scapula, and the posterior bone scapula. Coming to the next slice, you see here again the trachea, the esophagus. This is the right lung. Lung contains air, that is why it is black. This is a mediastinal window of the CT scan and not a lung window. That is why the lung appears jet black. You do not see the vascular markings here. This is the left lung. These are the ribs. The ribs, and this is the vertebra. Structure 9 is the transverse process of the vertebra, which is forming this joint with the rib. So that's the costovertebral joint here. We saw that this posterior bone is the scapula. Now if we come to the next section, again this is trachea, the esophagus. This is a very important section which you need to identify for your exams. So you see this 4 vessels here. So what do you see is, there are these 3 vessels, 1, 2 and 3. So basically these are branches of the aortic arch. From right to left, we know that the branches are brachiocephalic trunk, left common carotid and left subclavian artery. The mnemonic is BCS. From right to left, so brachiocephalic trunk, left common carotid, left subclavian artery, very important to identify. The vessel here, anterior to this branches of the aorta, is the brachiocephalic vein. So that's the left brachiocephalic vein. This is the right brachiocephalic vein.